Welcome back to the channel. Truly thank you for the recent 100 subscribers that I reached in my channel. Right now I can quite feel the responsibility to bring new content, interesting and also useful for everybody. Therefore, I want to stick to my journey, to relate my journey with all of you, and also to improve day by day my knowledge and my way to explain to people, and also to share with them as simple as possible ways to secure, to improve, to hack in the best way as possible. Therefore, right now I want to share with you this bunch of video in relation to how to set a proxy as quick as possible in a simple way, utilizing Amazon Web Service, which on it we can use the WAF to secure connection without using AP tables. And you will see during this video how to improve it, how to make it in the first video as simple as possible, and after make it more secure as possible, and also make some restriction on website that you can visit or not. I will try to in future to upload a video per week if it's possible, because therefore I'm working and also studying in my extra time in order to be more prepared as possible and to reach my own goals. And I hope you will enjoy this kind of video. See you in the future. Well, the purpose of this video is to set the proxy in order to change our ordinary location of our IP. Now we'll see how to set it as quick as possible. First, we need to create a key pair. This key pair will allow us to access the SSH protocol. And once we download it, we can use the full position or change it. In my case, I like to put all the things that I will use in this video in this directory. One thing that we need to remember is to change the permission in order to make executable the file. As you can see, we can use a command change mode plus 6. This will make executable the file. And right now I was having already another instance. So if you want to stop it, you can use this action. But I like to create a new instance in order to let you see how it's simple to configure a server or instances that you want to use for different kind of purpose. To create one instance, we need to go to launch instances and press on the button. And as you can see, we can set the name and we have also a quick start. And I set the IP which we will use to access the machine through SSH. You can set it after, but I prefer to set it before. But also you will be able to set it once the machine is enabled. One thing that we need to remember is to insert the key pair to access the machine. This will allow us to access it with just and only with the SSH key in order to secure it. And usually when the machine starts, it takes like 2-3 minutes to be fully ready to utilize it. So as you can see, we will have an IPv4 address. This usually is generated every time the machine starts. So remember that when you terminate the instance and when you will restart again, the IP could change and you need to be aware of, about it, because this could not allow you to use the proxy. As you can see right now, we are trying to access the machine through the SSH protocol, and I want to let you see the usual step that you can go and make error on it. As you can see, the first one that we it suggests us to change the permission because the key is to open, and to do this kind of things we can change the permission. We change mode 700, which will allow just the user to execute and to modify and write the file. And also let's change the key to the owner root. This will secure as full as possible the key. And in fact, to run all the command in relation with this key, we need to use the command sudo. As you can see right now, if we run without sudo, we are not able to access the machine. But if we run with sudo, we can access it. But there is another small problem that we will encounter if you try to access with root, that the machine is suggesting us to use the AC2 user, which is a user that it's inserted into the sudoers file, and it has a lot of privileges, but not all of it. And this also will help us to not make too much damage inside the machine. As you can see right now, we are inside the machine, and to set up this proxy, we need to enable Squid, which is a program very popular to set as quick as possible the proxy. This HEAC2 distribution is based on UM repository. As you can see, if we run the command apt get install squid, this command will not be found, but we could use the UM repository or DNF repository, the one that you prefer, and you run the command UM install squid, and you install all the things required to make it works. After this, we need to run this command systemctl enable squid. First, let's run status to see that is dead currently, and let's enable it. Enable squid will allow the machine every time on the boot to start up this service. Therefore, we will not be required to start it. So this also could be helpful, that if we need the proxy, we just need to start the instance through the interface of Amazon Web Service. And once it's running up, we just need to figure it out what is the current IP. With that one, we can access the proxy as quick as possible and as simple as possible. As you can see right now, the service is running, and we can also use the command system status squid.service-l to see all the log stack, the full one, if we need to watch it in a deep way. But right now we need to make and set few steps in order to make all the process work. First, let's access the squid.conf with sudo to be able to modify it. We just need to make a small change in this file, because fortunately, using the Amazon Web Service, all the connection are controlled on that side. So we just need to change HTTP underscore access and change deny all with allow all, and let's save the current modification. Right now we need to reload the service in order to make permanently running the last modification that we made. Now there is just few steps that we need to take. We need to set, in this case, I will set it through Foxy Proxy, the extension that you can install on Google, Chrome, or also on Firefox. And we need to insert the actual IP address. This will change our current one on my location. And we need to insert the default port that usually is the 3.1.2.8, the default one, but you can change it. And in this case, we will use the default one, and let's insert the port and let's save it also. Now we need to select the proxy that we want to use. Let's select the last one that we add. And as you can see right now, we are not able to access Google. We need to make some few addition in the security group of the Amazon Web Server interface. This could be a little bit boring, but also is useful to secure your machine without being too a pro to do it with IP tables or other kind of. So as you can see, we can access the security groups here, and we need to set the inbound rules, because the outbound rules right now is 0.0.0.0, which is the default route to the internet. So we need just to add our current IP address. Remember that if you are using a router and you don't off it usually, you will have always the same IP address. But in my case, I was using my phone, my internet phone connection, so I think another time that I want to access this machine, the IP could change. So you need to access another time this security group and add your current IP. These are the settings that you need to add: HTTP, HTTPS, and all traffic. And this will allow us to use fully our proxy and without any kind of problem and without any kind of restriction. And as you can see right now, if we reload the mylocation.org, our IP is settled in Japan, Tokyo. And most of the time, this could be useful if we want to buy things with different kind of discount, like flights or other kind of. If you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe. See you soon.